The Odd Couple 2. Forgettable comedy. Alas, it has Walter Matthau and Jack Lemmon, two departed sacred monsters of cinema and in particular comedy. Well, no, that's a mistake. Strike that. I'm thinking Days of Wine and Roses, for instance, and that's not a comedy, that's a tragedy, really. The trauma of alcoholism. So, Jack Lemmon has been in many, many films that are drama, not in the drama category, not comedies. So, yes, there's perhaps the best one ever, according to some prestigious critics. The American Film Institute may have some Like It Hot on the top number one spot, and if not, it's in the top 5, 10, 4. Well, everybody maybe. So nobody's perfect. They say that's the best ending line in history. Jack Lemmon and his would-be husband, well, fiance anyway, in Some Like It Hot. So there is that. There's The Apartment, of course, classics. But this one is far, far from the original, The Odd Couple, which was excellent. There is a feeling of sympathy, I don't know, nostalgia, and it's pleasant to watch these giants. Only the text is so lame, so boring that I don't know. It's in a way regrettable that they wasted the talent. It's also true the two artists are tired, I guess. Anyway, we're supposed to follow them as the daughter of Jack Lemmon's character marries the son of the enemy, Walter Matthau's personage. And they meet at the airport, they clash, so Jack Lemmon, let's stick with that. I forgot what the name of the actors, what the names of the actors are in the movie. Has an accident and has problems moving. He is, anyway, his character is given an annoying profile in the plane. He's upset by the perfume of the lady on his left. Then also the cologne of the guy on the right. He wanted to eat some kind of fish, which is not available. It was available as they were going south or southeast. Now it's not. So he wants to move from this place, but the plane is full. It's before the pandemic. It's maybe 2 decades ago when they made the movie. So he's anyway annoying. But I'm thinking some funny moments. The annoyance on the plane is not translated into laughs, though, I think. in the car at one point, so he has ice on his leg because he has fallen. He had fallen. So with the ice melting, he wants to throw it out. Open the window, he tells the driver, Martha. It's open. And he throws the bucket into the window, and then it falls back all over him, because that was a joke. The window was not open. And as if he couldn't tell. Well, I don't know. It was funny to see it coming back on his face, but otherwise the usual cliche, many times seen before, is there's an omnipresent of the feeling of deja vu. They forget the suitcase at the airport. They have problems. He wants to pee, then he wants to eat, and then his partner wants a calendar of programming. When do you have to pee? When do you have to eat? When, so that we know to make these stops. And once when they stop, they get into a fight on the matter of the suitcase, which is back, which has his tuxedo, has, I don't know, $10,000, has the special gift when for the wedding, the upcoming wedding, that's why they're there. Only they don't know where they're going, San, and then they go through the San Diego, San Francisco, everything with San in California. All the cities have San before. So it was San Marino, maybe. So anyway, as they stop on the side of the road, Lemon slaps the car, and the car gets back into a ravine and then explodes. So, laughs, I don't know, some smiles, yeah, maybe 3, 4, 5 even. But otherwise, a waste of talent.